Hello everybody, my name is Pirmin. I'm a member of the EPLAN support team at Pilz. In this tutorial, I'd like to show you how to use the Pilz PLC macros. To use our macros, you need EPLAN version 2.9, update 6 or higher. Our macros are available in the EPLAN data portal or can be downloaded from our homepage. In the first step, I start EPLAN Platform 2023. And open a prepared customer project PNOZmulti 2. Page number 4 to 6 are PLC overview pages. Page number 7 is a single line page for the bus structure. Page number 8 is a multi-line page for the 24-volt supply of the PNOZmulti 2 modules. Page number 9 is a multi-line page for the test pulses. Page number 11 is a prepared multi-line page with e-stop and the feedback loop. Before we can get started, I check my article database. I go to Master Data, Management, and open the settings. Pilz Artikelstammdaten is the right database. I continue with OK. In the next step, we download the articles from the EPLAN data portal. Therefore, go to the EPLAN cloud and open the data portal. I select the manufacturer Pilz. And type in 772-100 for the basic module PNOZ MB0. I choose the module and click to import. Set the HUC to accessories and manufacturer data and click to OK. I do the same for the field bus module 772137. You also can find the EPLAN macros on the Pilz website. See the link in the video description. I go back to my customer project and search for the 772137 standard EtherCAT communication module and place it with drag and drop on my PLC overview page number 5. I go on page number 6 and place the PLC overview for module 772100 PNOZ MB0 head module. I click to edit in the main menu and switch off the consider grouping option and change the device tag to A1.0. Next, I like to place the rack overview on page number 4. Open the PLC Navigator. You will find it under the Device tab. Set up the view to channel oriented. Navigate to the communication module A1. Use drag and drop to place the PLC overview. Do the same for the field bus communication module. Now I open page number 7. It is a single line page. Place the field bus connection point X1 via drag and drop on the page. Next page is a multi-line page for the 24-volt DC supply of my basic module PNOZ MB0. I mark X4 connection point 5 and place it with drag and drop on the multiline page. I do the same for the second supply. On page number 9, I place the test pulses. Place channel 20 via drag and drop on the multiline page. Do the same with test pulse T1. On page 11, it's a schematic diagram of an emergency stop application with a feedback loop. Place channel 4, input 4, and connect it to the first e-stop channel. Go on with the same procedure for channel 5 to 7. The outputs, channel 24 and 25, are also connected to the contactors according to this principle. Go back to page number 4, the rack view. I will show you how to complete the PLC configuration. Mark the module A1.0 and press the right mouse key. Open the global properties. Move down to the PLC card name and type in A1.0. Start address is 0. Click to apply. Switch to the tab PLC structure data. Choose the name of your PLC project. For example, PNOZmulti 2. Station ID is station 1. PLC card is placed on rack 1. The position is also 1. Check the box for CPU. Click to apply. Click to the CPU name 1 and open the field. Click to apply and confirm with OK. Use the command update connections. Finally, you can see the PLC configuration in your rack. Do the same for the communication module. Now you can integrate our latest PLC macros according to the EPLAN Data Standard into your day-to-day business. The big advantage is that our macros for the compact controller, PNOZmulti, and the PLC PSS 4000 work according to the exact same principle. I hope I have been able to improve your knowledge of EPLAN with the short tutorial. If you enjoyed this tutorial, I would be delighted if you liked the video and to subscribe to the channel, that you are stayed informed when new tutorials are released. If you like to take a look to how to configure a safe cardboard feeder with EPLAN and EBuild 3, I have linked the video here. See you next. Bye bye.